I'm Kei Noda from Department of Electronics and Electrical Engineering at Keio University, Japan. From now, I will talk about our recent results on anodized metal oxide nanotubular arrays for gas phase photocatalysis and photoinduced high purity hydrogen production. Electrochemical anodization is one of the surface finishing techniques for various transition metals. Anodization will lead to the formation of metal oxide layers on the metal surfaces. In particular, when electrolytes, including both fluoride and polyols for anodic metal oxides, is used, self-aligned nanotubular arrays can be prepared, as shown in this slide. Actually, well-aligned metal oxide nanotubes of wide-bandgap oxide semiconductors, such as titanium dioxide, TiO2, and hematite, αFe2O3, with smooth walls can be formed. These self-aligned nanotubular structures with large specific surface areas are intensely examined toward photocatalytic and photoelectrochemical applications due to their attracting features such as simplicity and low-cost fabrication. First of all, in this presentation, I will talk about photocatalytic properties of hematite nanotubular arrays. Hematite is a traditional but promising candidate as a visible light responsive photocatalyst with an indirect bandgap energy of 2.2 electron volt. The potential application of hematite will be economically viable, since iron is one of the most abundant metals on the Earth. However, hematite has rapid electron hole pair recombination and poor electrical conductivity. To overcome these disadvantages, various researches, including material synthesis, doping, theoretical calculation, have been widely conducted. With this background, self-aligned hematite nanotubes have been expected toward high-performance photocatalytic applications such as water splitting. This slide shows how we prepared hematite nanotubular arrays. Hematite nanotubular arrays were fabricated by two-step anodization method. After the first anodization process, the anodized iron sheet was sonicated in organic solvents to clean the sample surface. Then, we performed second anodization process, and the uniformly anodized iron oxide with red-brown color was obtained. After that, the anodized samples were annealed in oxygen atmosphere for crystallization in hematite phase. The scanning electron microscope images of the samples show vertically aligned nanotubular structures with an average pore diameter of 20 nanometer and length exceeding 2 micrometer. For aiming at solar hydrogen production, the energy band structure of photocatalytic materials should be considered. Hematite itself is not capable of generating hydrogen because its energy level of the conduction band edge is more positive than the hydrogen reduction potential. Therefore, loading co-catalysts that promote proton reduction is essential toward solar hydrogen production based on hematite nanotubular arrays. Here, we have focused on p-type cuprous oxide, Cu2O, as one of the co-catalysts for hematite, because Cu2O possesses a bandgap of 2.1 electron volt, and its conduction band edge is located more negative related to the hydrogen reduction potential. Moreover, the employment of noble metal-free co-catalysts such as Cu2O is desirable in terms of cost effectiveness and sustainability. this work, we utilize the pulse electrodeposition method for CuO nanoparticle growth. Pulse electrodeposition has advantages in uniform and dense deposition of small nanoparticles. Then, photocatalytic hydrogen production with the composites of hematite nanotubular arrays and cuprous oxide nanoparticles was examined in a homemade measurement setup, as shown in this slide. The hydrogen amount from the decomposition of gaseous mixture of water and methanol with a mixing ratio of 1:1 was evaluated by using a gas chromatography. The measurement cell was connected to the gas chromatograph via the gas sampler. Prior to visible light irradiation, the gas lines were purged with nitrogen gas several times. Generated gases over the sample under the light irradiation were stored and circulated continuously by using an air pump and nitrogen as carrier gas. The condition of light irradiation was written in this slide. This slide presents the data plots of the hydrogen amount and the light irradiation time for the composite sample of hematite and CuO, only hematite, only CuO, and platinum-loaded hematite samples. The hematite CuO composite revealed hydrogen production under visible light irradiation. However, hydrogen production could not be detected with other three samples. These results indicate CuO nanoparticles deposited on hematite nanotubular arrays plays an important role in reducing protons to hydrogen, owing to its conduction band level more negative than the hydrogen reduction potential. Thus, cuprous oxide nanoparticles can work as noble metal-free co-catalysts for gas phase photocatalysis based on visible light responsive n-type semiconductors. A series of results in this study can open up possibilities for photocatalytic application of anodized hematite nanotubular arrays and electrodeposited CuO nanoparticles. Well, I'll move on to the next topic on high-purity hydrogen production. Considering the hydrogen gas supply for practical uses, all the hydrogen reforming units must be followed by hydrogen purification units for separating generated hydrogen from other byproduct gases, such as carbon dioxide and oxygen. This issue can limit the miniaturization of hydrogen production systems and the further development of on-site reformers toward mobile application of hydrogen energy. For solving issues on hydrogen usage mentioned in the previous slide, we proposed a photoactive hydrogen production separation membrane which consists of an array of nanotubular photocatalysts and a hydrogen permeable metal, as shown in this slide. The whole thickness of this membrane reactor was only several micrometers. Here, anodized titanium dioxide nanotubular array was employed as a photocatalyst and electrolysis-plated palladium thin film as a hydrogen purification part. Liquid or vapor fuels, such as alcohols or water, can be reformed by photocatalysis on TiO2. The hollow parts of titanium nanotubular arrays serve as a path for generated hydrogen to the inner surface of a palladium layer. And then, highly purified hydrogen gas was obtained quickly from the backside of the palladium layer. A layer membrane of TiO2 nanotubular array and palladium was prepared as follows. The anodized titanium sheet was coated with a palladium film via electrolysis plating. Palladium nanoparticle cores for initiating growth of an electrorespirated pallidum layer were formed on the aperture of the nanotubes by photodeposition. After the electrorespirating of pallidum, the pallidum-coated nanotubular array samples was annealed in a vacuum furnace. Then, the pallidum film was mechanically peeled off from the anodized titanium sheet for completing the bilayer membrane as shown in this slide. Photocatalytic hydrogen production and separation in the membrane were examined with a homemade measurement cell as shown in this slide. In order to mount the membrane in the measurement cell, the membrane was glued on another titanium sheet with an aperture by using epoxy resin. The titanium sheet with the membrane specimen was mounted in the middle part of the cell and tightly sealed with O-rings, so that only the TiO2 part of the membrane was exposed to fuel solutions. The mixture of pure water and methanol was deposited onto the membrane specimen until the membrane surface became fully covered with a droplet. Generated gases filtered through the membrane under ultraviolet irradiation were stored and circulated continuously by using an air pump and carrier gas. The stored gas was analyzed with gas chromatograph online by employing the gas sampler. For investigating temperature dependence, the membrane temperature was changed by controlling the temperature of a ceramic heater located underneath the membrane sample. This slide shows data plots of the hydrogen production amount against the duration of the UV radiation at various heater temperatures. The obtained hydrogen gas amount was proportional to the UV radiation time for initial several hours, and an inflection point where the hydrogen production rate drastically increased was observed. Moreover, the hydrogen production rate became larger at higher heater temperature. In addition, the maximal values of high purity hydrogen production rate from this sacrificial water splitting and its apparent quantum yield were 2.7 micromole per hour per square centimeter and 3.6% respectively at the heater temperature of 90 degrees C. In this membrane, both hydrogen permission and adsorption process occur simultaneously at the initial stage of photo-induced hydrogen production and separation. When the hydrogen storage amount reaches the limit after the UV radiation for several hours, only hydrogen permission is permitted in the pallidum layer, and the effective hydrogen production rate in the membrane rapidly increases. This mechanism can be one of the reasons for the inflection points. The photoactive membranes described here and their further optimization will contribute to developing practical compact photoreforming systems as a sustainable energy resource. This is a summary of my talk. I mainly presented visible light responsive gas phase photocatalysis over the anodized hematite nanotubular arrays loaded with CuO2 nanoparticles and photo-induced high-purity hydrogen production based on the bilayer membrane of the anodized TiO2 nanotubular arrays and pallidum layer. Thank you very much for your kind attention.